Hello students, welcome back to the class, and today I am going to talk about the complex permanent tissues. In the previous class we have discussed about the parenchyma, sclerenchyma and collenchyma. If you want to revisit those videos and have a recapitulation, click on the I button and you can find those videos over there. Complex permanent tissues. Before proceeding into it, we should know why they are called as complex permanent tissues. Here, more than one type of cell, they should be having common origin and they perform specific function. So this is the difference between a simple permanent tissue and complex permanent tissues. In the previous lecture only I have told you that complex permanent tissues are categorized into two types, xylem and phloem. Collectively, they are called as vascular tissues. Why they are called as the vascular tissues? Because they are functioning towards the transport of water and food required by the plants for their own physiological activities. So that is how we come across the types of the complex permanent tissues. Now, we will understand each of them in specific detail. Let us first of all talk about the xylem. Xylem is a vascular tissue and this is generally called as wood. तो हम लोग जो बात करते हैं wood की, this is the wood. Okay. Xylem has four components. Okay. Xylem is a complex permanent tissue and as I have told you earlier that they contain more than one type of cell but of common origin. So the xylem is having four components and these four components are tracheids, vessels, xylem parenchyma and xylem fibers. So what is the common point between them? That xylem tracheids, vessels and fibers are sclerenchymatous, but xylem parenchyma is parenchymatous, a living tissue which is present. So this is how the four components are present, and all of them they carry out a single specific function, that is to transport water and minerals. They transport the water and minerals from the roots to the leaves, right? So this is how the movement of water takes place. If we say that the movement of water takes place from the roots to the leaves, it is only in one direction. So we can also say that the movement of the water and minerals unidirectional. It cannot be in the other direction, okay, because of the presence of water. So this is how the xylem is understood. In this diagram, I wanted to give you an idea that how these components of xylem are arranged or they are present. You can see this tapered ends of the long elongated tissues or cells, they are the tracheids. The broad ended cells which are arranged end to end with their components, they are called as vessels. They are broad, and the third one are the long elongated cells which are fibrous, and they are the xylem fibers. All of them are sclerenchymatous and they are dead tissues, so they help in the conduction of the water from the roots to the leaves. Okay, and also we will find some dots are there. These dots which are present in all these elements, okay, they are called as pits. They are the open areas which are formed from the plasmodesmata in the cell walls. So this is how we have understood about one vascular tissue, that is xylem. Next, proceed further into studying of phloem. Phloem is also a vascular tissue. It helps in the conduction of food. As xylem transports water, phloem transports food, and the transportation of the food is also called as translocation. It also is made up of four different types of the
cells which make up the phloem vascular tissue. The first one is called as phloem parenchyma. Next is sieve elements, sieve tubes or sieve elements. Third is called as companion cell, and the fourth one is called as phloem fibers. So out of them, they are living in nature, whereas the phloem fiber is dead and it is sclerenchymatous in nature. Thus, phloem fibers provide the support to the structures which are present or which form the phloem tissue. So the conduction of the food takes place from the leaves to the storage organs. Leaves themselves are the storage organs. We are talking about the storage organs in stem, in the roots, in the flowers. So we find that the storage organs can be any of the part of the plant where we which is edible, which contains the which is consumed by the animals as a food. So the movement of the food is in multiple directions, and that is why the movement or translocation or the conduction of substances through the phloem is called as multidirectional. It is said to be bidirectional also. So that is how the phloem tissue is understood. If you see in diagram, then these broad vessels which I am showing here, these are called as sieve elements, or you can say sieve tubes, okay, which are joined end to end. At the junction of two sieve tubes, you will find this is called as sieve plate, and the sieve plates are porous. The sieve plates are porous so that the food can easily get moved out of it or transported across. The second component is the cells which are attached alongside the sieve tubes. These are called as companion cells. Companion cells have these nucleus. So the nucleus is present in the companion cells, which is shared by the sieve tube also. Because sieve tube, though it is a living tissue or living cell, they do not contain or they do not have the nucleus of their own. The third component of this phloem tissue I have shown here is the phloem fibers. So phloem fibers, again, they have the supportive function, other three components or other two components of the phloem tissue. So this is how we have understood the details of the complex permanent tissue about xylem and phloem individually. I hope you have understood this concept. You have liked the content. Put your comments in the comment box. If you haven't subscribed the channel yet, please subscribe to the channel and share the channel among your friends and relatives also. Thank you for watching this video.